What's up, guys? Chris 60 here. Welcome to the channel where I don't rest until we get you that girl you want, that girl you like. She becomes your girlfriend. It's the girl you're crazy about. She's crazy about you. You're going on vacations, spending time together. You're happy. You say, Chris, thank you so much. I've never felt better in my life. That's the goal of the channel. That's why you tune in, and that's why we go over these lessons. So today I want to take a question from a guy in our community here. His name is Laughing Fox here on YouTube, and he sent me a question. He wanted to know about the friend zone. So today we're going to talk about three ways you end up in the friend zone. Now you might be thinking, the friend zone, this topic has been talked about to death. I know all about this, but I want to look at it from a different angle today. So we'll look at three ways you end up in the friend zone. The three main ways, really. So the first one is this. You end up in the friend zone when you are lured by being vague to avoid rejection, okay? If there's a little opportunity that you can be vague instead of having to take the risk and ask a girl out, ask a girl for her number, you'll take the vague road because you're like, man, I can bypass rejection. I'll give you an example. If you work with a girl and you like her, you know her number's on the office sheet, or maybe you got her number through a work assignment, or maybe it's at school and you get her number because you're working together on a project. You don't have to ask for her number. So you go, woo, I can bypass that. I have her number already. I don't have to say, hey, can I get your phone number, right? So you take that opportunity. The problem with that is you leave bold points on the table. There's only so many bold points you can get. And again, if we look at love and attraction as a score, if she gave you a score of 65, but you did something bold, like ask her for her number, she's going to bump you up 2 or 3 points, right? But if you never ask and you just got her number because you're doing some project in a group together, you leave those points on the table, right? You leave the bold points on the table. Same thing if you never had to go up and actually start a conversation with her. You met her online, on an app. Your friend introduced you, it's a group. Hey, cool, you know her now. You left those bold points on the table. You're still in that 60 range. You could have got a few, right? Same thing with the date. You leave a lot of bold points on the table. You keep it vague. You didn't ask her out specifically for a date. You and a bunch of friends were getting together to hang out at a bar or at a party or wherever, right? You wanted to keep it vague because you didn't want to risk rejection by actually asking her out. You're like, yeah, when we hang out, then I'll make my move, then I'll do my thing. You kept it vague. You left these points on the table. And today, a lot of us guys are leaving points on the table because a lot of stuff is meeting girls online. You know, you don't even need the number at that point. You don't ask them on a date. It's all hanging out. So it's all fine and dandy, but you're not getting the most attraction points you could get. You're leaving those on the table. So anytime you're vague and it's not clear, you kind of steer yourself into the friend zone, right? Because you're not clearly stating your intention. And you're doing that to try to avoid rejection. Listen, I know why we do it, right? If there's an easier way, we're going to try to take that path. But that's what leads you down the road. So making it clear from the beginning, I'm asking for your number, I'm asking you on a date, that takes all that friend zone stuff out of it, at least at the beginning, right? So that's the first way you can kind of end up in the friend zone, being vague. The second way has to do with the vibe between you and her and the connection, right? Words are part of it and conversation is part of it, but it's really what happens when you're not talking, okay? Those moments when you're not speaking, the silences, the eye contact, the vibe, the mood, the body language, right? In those moments, there will be a few of these moments, and these are key moments when they pop up, right? Everything else is talking and conversation and getting along. But when these moments pop up, where you hold eye contact with her, and there's a silence or a pause in the conversation, or you get a little too close accidentally, if you react to that moment with fear, and you kind of nervous, and you fidget, or you move back suddenly, or you look away quickly when you were looking at her, in those moments, those romantic tension type moments, you're going to end up in the friend zone. Okay? I'm not saying you got to make a move really fast, you got to kiss her really fast, but if in those moments you get scared, nervous, and fidget around, you're going to be seen as more of a friend because you can't handle that romantic tension between a man and a woman that shows up, okay? There are little tells that, you know what, with this guy, I just don't feel it. I don't feel the connection. We're not talking about a verbal connection like we both love to play cards or we both, you know, enjoy going bowling. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about that nonverbal connection, right? The look, the feel, the closeness, all that stuff. If you react scared in those moments, you're going to be slotted into the friend zone. So that's two ways so far. If you're not vague and you get all your bold points and you can stand tough in those moments of romantic tension and not fidget around or get nervous, she will definitely see you as more than a friend, right? You'll be on the road to getting there. But there's one final one. There's a third thing that leads you into the friend zone. So now we will talk about the verbal stuff, right? Sometimes you can be too good verbally. You could be too good at giving her advice. You could be too good with the life lessons and like you're some kind of mentor and helping her out with her problems, okay? This leads you to the friend zone. But because what you become in her mind is like a really good therapist. And hey, during these times, we could all use a really great therapist, right? But when you do that for her, she elevates you almost higher than even a guy she would want to date and be with. You're like untouchable. Like, oh, this is the guy I get the life advice from. This is the guy who gives me my daily inspiration and quotes. This guy's great. And you get slotted in more into the friendship role. Someone she wouldn't even want to risk dating because he listens to all my problems and he's good at solving them and he knows about life and he's great. You get slotted into that friend zone. Someone I never want to lose by dating them and having fun and having a fling with this guy. I want him around for the life advice, the daily quotes, the inspirational memes. This guy's great. And that's a mistake you make because you're so eager to connect when you first meet her that you listen to her issues and you try to solve them instead of, hey, you can listen, but you don't have to try to solve every problem. Problem with that too that leads you to the friend zone is since she's sharing her issues and problems, you feel like I'm going to unburden all my issues. Let me talk about the relationship that went wrong. For you married guys in the past, you talk about the divorce, right? And all that stuff. You've been dying to get this stuff off your chest, especially to a woman, because your friends aren't going to listen to all this stuff. That you're unburdening all these things, and now you're making her into like, you know, a mother figure instead of a girl you're trying to date. So you have this kind of relationship with each other where you're her therapist, she's acting like your mother, and you're going to end up in the friend zone. So guys, really, those are three ways. And listen, a lot has been said and written about this topic, but from the coaching I've done with guys, I really see these three things pop up again and again for why you end up in the friend zone. If you're vague and not bold at the beginning, friend zone. If you don't have that romantic vibe, that nonverbal connection with her, friend zone. If you try too hard to have that verbal connection with her and go more into that therapy, I'm going to help you, inspirational mentor role, friend zone. Those are three ways. So those are three ways you can avoid that fate and instead be the guy that she wants to date. Guys, thanks so much. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. It helps the video more than you know, and I'll see you in the next one. For more coaching lessons or to get coaching from Chris directly, or if you want to tell me about what's going on with your situation, click the link below and we'll start helping you right away.